What's going on, all of my healthcare brothers and sisters? I hope that you are having a wonderful day. Today, we are helping you pass your NCLEX and nursing school exams like a boss, and we're going to be looking at lab results, specifically your white blood cells. Let's get our nurse on. So to begin with, let's talk about whole blood products. So when we're looking at our complete blood counts, or CBCs, this is the general overview of what's in our whole blood products. So our blood is about 55% plasma and 45% formed elements. Our plasma is made up of 91% water, 7% proteins. That includes our albumins, our globulins, fibrinogen, and prothrombin. 2% other solutes, gases, ions, nutrients, regulatory substances, as well as waste products. Our formed elements are our red blood cells, which is usually in the millions, platelets, and our white blood cells, which can be further broken down into neutrophils, eosinophils, lymphocytes, basophils, and monocytes. So in this video, we're specifically looking at white blood cells. And the definition for them is it's a type of blood cell that is made in the bone marrow and is found in blood and lymph tissue. So white blood cells are part of the body's immune system. They help the body fight infection as well as other diseases, and they are different depending on what their function is. So we have neutrophils, bands, eosinophils, basophils, lymphocytes, and monocytes. So the normal generalized range of white blood cells is between 4,000 and 10,000. And again, they respond to infection, inflammation, and stress found throughout the body. So what is the pathophysiology of our white blood cells? Well, as we learned before, they are formed in the bone marrow. And the primary function of white blood cells is they are responsible for immune system defense and phagocytosis of foreign substances. So they're really responsible for inflammation response, and they respond to, again, those infections, inflammation, and stress indicators found throughout our body. So as we know, normal white blood cell counts are between 4,000 and 10,000, but many white blood cell labs are going to come back with white blood cell differentials. So it's important to know specifically what the normal values are for each substance of white blood cell that's going to be found in your differential. So you're going to have neutrophils, which is 45 to 75% is normal. Bands, which are young neutrophils, are typically between 0 to 5%. If it's greater than 8%, that's something that we call a left shift. That means there could be some kind of infection or inflammation taking place in the body. Lymphocytes, again, 20 to 40%. Monocytes, 10 to 8%. Eosinophils, 0 to 6%. And basophils, less than 1%. If any of these numbers are abnormal, then that lets us know specifically what's taking place in the body so that we can treat it appropriately. What does our white blood cell differentials tell us? Well, we know with our neutrophils, they help heal damaged tissues and resolve infections. So the increase in the response of infections, injury, and stress. When it comes to our lymphocytes, they're broken down into two categories. We have our T cells and we have our B cells. Our T cells direct fighters of foreign invaders and produce cytokines to activate other parts of the immune system. Our B cells produce antibody molecules that will latch on and destroy these invading viruses and bacteria. So typically, they just respond to any kind of foreign invaders. When it comes to our monocytes, they help us fight bacteria, viruses, and other infections through macrophages. Our eosinophils are usually linked to some kind of allergic reaction. So they help curb infections and boost inflammation to fight disease, and can be elevated when it comes to parasitic response. And lastly, our basophils. So again, allergic response due to some kind of anaphylactic reaction or asthma. So if you have a patient that has anaphylactic allergies to peanuts, you're going to see an increase in basophils if they were to eat a peanut and went into some kind of anaphylactic reaction. And I just wanted to take a moment to further break down bands, which we discussed earlier, which are our young neutrophils. So if we have a left shift where it's greater than 8, we have an increased number of immature neutrophils present in the blood. So a low white blood cell count with a left shift usually is recovery from bone marrow depression or a severe infection whose requirements for neutrophils exceeds the bone marrow's capacity to create them. Or if we have a high white blood cell count and left shift, it's an increased release in neutrophils by the bone marrow in response to an overwhelming infection or inflammation. We can also have a right shift. It's not as common as the left, but we can also have a right shift when it comes to our bands, and that is the ratio of immature to mature neutrophils, and it's usually our reduced young neutrophils. So if you have a patient who has Down syndrome, megaloblastic, or as well as pernicious anemia, you're going to see right shifts in that band formation. So when it comes to obtaining white blood cell count labs, you're going to be using the lavender top tube with EDTA. It's got that anti-clotting to keep blood from clotting within the tube. So really the technique when it comes to this tube is that every tube has a negative pressure inside. So once the needle is inserted into the tube, blood is supposed to rush in. You never want to push blood into a test tube because it can actually cause hemolysis, which is the breaking down of blood cells, and it will decrease the overall red blood cell count and can lead to wrong treatment. So always consider your needle size as well as your tubing. It should be at least a 20 gauge needle for best results, so that way we can get the blood accurately and treat the patient appropriately. So if we have abnormal values, what are the potential causes? Well, if we have leukocytosis, which is also known as elevated white blood cells, we know that there's some kind of infection, inflammation, or stress taking place inside the body. So again, an allergic reaction, you can see an increase in those eosinophils and basophils, asthma, inflammatory disease of the heart. After a patient has had a myocardial infarction, you can see an increase and white blood cell counts because the need to dispose of the necrotic tissue resulting from that infarction. You can also see it in trauma, stress, as well as pregnancy. And on the other end of the spectrum, you have leukopenia, which means a decrease in white blood cells. And with this, you can primarily see the causes as cancer, if they're receiving any kind of chemotherapy, radiation, systemic lupus is another big one, it's an autoimmune disease. Leukopenia and neutropenia are more common when the patient is experiencing active lupus, as well as some medications can actually cause a decrease in white blood cells. So your antibiotics, anticonvulsants, antihistamines, antithyroid medications, barbiturates, and diuretics can overtly cause a decrease in white blood cell counts. So if we do have a decrease in white blood cell counts, the primary function is to help with the system's immunity. So if it is decreased, we no longer have that system immunity protection. So we usually place these patients on neutropenic precautions. And that is because of that lower immune system, like we discussed before, and the body's inability to fight off infections. So usually that consists of us wearing appropriate PPE. So that's going to be our gown, our mask, our gloves, our goggles, whatever it is that we can protect on us from getting to the patient. Because normally we wear our PPE to protect us. In this situation, we're wearing our PPE to protect them. I hope that these videos were helpful for you in passing your NCLEX and nursing school exams like a boss. If you haven't done so already, make sure that you subscribe and turn on that notification bell. That way you're informed every time I post a new video here on Nurse Cheung. Make sure you follow me on my social media. I'm on Facebook and Instagram. And check out my website at www.nursecheung.com, where I've posted additional resources such as NCLEX-style questions to help you pass those exams, resources, cheat sheets, and so much more. Until next time, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you all again soon. Bye!